load and go, but I just want you to be able to change directions and then finish into the midline. We good with those three? Here we go. Good, on top. Good. Oh, good. Good, on top. Good. Good, on top. Oh, on top. My hands low, you're hot. Good. Perfect. Down low. Bang, good. Perfect, come on. Good, on top. Nice. Come on, on top. Good, here we go. Good. Nice. Good, on top. Good. On top. Good. Get low, get low. Good, here we go. Good, on top. Nice. Here we go. Yep. Come on, on top. Nice, on top. Good. You get that good range, good. Hey, come on. Nice, on top. Perfect. Change the directions. Oh, hands high, go low. Good, here we go. Nice, go to top. Perfect. Good, perfect. Nice, good. Your first one, right? Perfect. Good finish right there. So that's the first thing we do. Now, the second thing we're going to do is it's going to be a little bit more realistic. I'm going to have you guys partner up. So the guy behind you, so you set the ball down, you set the ball down, you set the ball down, and you set the ball down. Here's what the drill is. I'm right here, I'm your partner, so you're going to be right on my side, okay? What you're going to do is you got the ball, and you're just going to drop the ball in front of him, okay? Drop the ball in front. So it's here, drop. Now obviously in the game, this is where you're going to be at a lot, right on the side. So when you drop the ball in front, now we're alive. I don't want you cheating, kind of going with the ball. You're going to let him have an advantage. You have to make a decision, can you finish? Or do you have to go pull back, results in mid-range? Or do you go pull back, the results in a change of direction? So if I go here, and you're sprinting, I'm on your hip, I'm probably going to finish it, right? If I go here, and I'm trying to cheat the drill, and go there, I might sprint, boom, you might pull back, get something right there. Or I might get you with a boom, you start to sprint, pull back, bang, I see it, and then you have to change directions. Okay? So you're the defender right here, get a little bit on the side, right there, you got the ball. You're a little bit over. You want a little bit of distance so they can't cheat, so a little bit over. Right there, you ready? Go, pass it, go. Good, finish it, perfect, next up. Good, pass it, go, go. Good, finish it, nice. Oops, get back, get back, I don't want you in front. I want you even, even, right there. Go, good, good. Don't lean over there for a layup. Who's up, who's with you, who's with you? Good, hold on. Yeah, there you go. That's what I want right there. You guys can be even. So like, this guy is here. That guy's there. And then pass him right here. Yep, that's where I want it, right there. That's how it should be right there, because that's game line. Yep, right there, go. Good, right there, go. Nice, good. That's what happens in the game. Good, go, good, tap. Nice, perfect, good. Tap. Nice, good stop. Good, that's okay, good, go. Perfect, good, go. Nice, tap. Nice job, that's okay. Good, go. Good change of direction, finish it. Good, next up, go. Nice. Perfect, good, that's okay. This is game line, go. Good. Good, here we go, next up, go. Nice, good, that's okay, go. And stop. So you can see these kind of drills, when you progressively build up, you can see kind of the finishing rate goes down, the mid-range goes down. I would highly encourage including competitive stuff in your guys' workouts. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a ball screen game. So you got the ball, you guys are on a single line right here, okay? I'm going to be the screener. Most of the time you'll have a coach with a pad right here. I'm just going to screen just because I don't want to use a pad, but I'm going to screen. What's going to happen is 13, you're guarding 11. And will you take my spot real quick so you just kind of, yep, right there, stand low and wide, okay? I'm going to take it to a certain size. This guy's going to take it to a certain side. He's going to stay within the middle third, and then he's going to say, screen. You're good right there. I'm going to stay right there. I'm just going to change my angle, put it there. What he has to do is he has to use a screen. If I come off right here, he cuts me off, I can try to reject. If I reject, I can go score at the rim. I can do whatever I want. If he plays me too much into the screen, so say he plays me on this side, and I split through before the screen, I can go get a layup as well. There's two rules. Number one is if he trails behind me, I cannot score in the paint. So I have to do a pocket jump shot, I have to tight wrap, I might have to hold him for a second and then separate off for a jump shot, but I can't get in the paint if he goes over top. Rule number two is, if he goes under the screen, so say you go there and you go under the screen to cheat, then I can either turn the corner or I can get one rescreen. So basically the only two rules are if he goes under, you get a rescreen, beats you this way, drill's over, because that means he didn't do his job. So they don't get to play one-on-one over there. We don't want to reward them because players love playing one-on-one. If they don't want him in the screen, they don't reject him, they don't split before, it's completely done. We understand you can go either side, too. You've got to talk to me because I'm not going to set the screen until you say screen, okay? Go. Good, I got you. Good, perfect. Nope, done. Didn't run him into the screen. Good, I'm here. Good, good, good. That's right, here we go, next up. And you guys can see this is what I'm talking about. How many players know how to get use the screen? None. Guys, hey, ho. We're playing one-on-one and you've got an extra guy. You're playing two-on-one right now. There is no way possible we shouldn't be getting layups. Come on, run him into the screen. Good, good, there you go. Now you can re-screen if you want it. You can re-screen if you want it. Perfect. Good job. That was actually a good possession right there. Here you go. Good. I got you. Use it. Use it. Use it. Good. That's all right. Good. Another screen. Get one re-screen. Good. And done. Done, done, done. Too many drums. Good. Here we go. This is the ball screen game that I would definitely recommend. Good. Catch off reject. Yes. Perfect. That's what we want right there. That's a great job. Great job. Come on. I'm here. I'm here. I'm here. Done, 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 done. Too many dribbles. Good. Over. Come on. Good. Done, done, done. Too many dribbles. Here we go. I'm here. I'm screening for you. I'm screening for you. Nice job. Good. Nice job. Good. Come on. Come on. Come on. Good. Nice. Good job. Don't score the lane. He goes over the top. Can't score the lane. Come on. Nice reject. Good. And stop. Now the reason I do this drill, and you guys saw this and you've never done this before, you guys see that why ball screens don't work at many levels. Because ball screens require players to be able to run their guy into the screen. If they can't do that, they can't run a ball screen. So if I was their coach, all I would do if they run a ball screen, I don't know if they run a motion or what you guys offense, but if they ran a ball screen, all I would do is this drill until they can just run their person in. Because if I'm here and say he's screening and you're guarding me, I'm not worried about flying off of this. I'm just here. You're guarding. Go ahead, guard me. I'm here. I'm here. I'm fine. I'm fine. Okay, now I run. And you see that little change of speed. I was walking. I have a thing in my pocket, and I easily got him to go under the screen. That's what good point guards, that's what good ball handlers do. So that's a great drill to work on it. Now we're going to do the same thing. You set the screen. You're going to be facing the basket. You're underneath the basket real quick, and we have you guard him real quick, and stand down the court real quick. You're going to be on offense. So 5 is on offense, 11 is on defense. One screener shooting a little bit. Yep, right there. I'm the passer. Here's what it is. You've got to get open on his screen. If you don't get open right here, so obviously you can have back door, you can do whatever. If you don't get open on the screen, then you've got one more chance. So he guards you, you come over, I'm going to nudge if I was you and try to get him going there. Say you don't get open. All you're going to do is pop back to the corner, flip the screen, and now you get one wide pin down. Now you're going to set him up, either go back door or use the screen and try to get a wide pin down. So your angles are going to be, and I'm going to set these screens anyway, but they'd be here, or basically your butt or your chest is to the rim, butt's to where you want them to go in that hollow area. And then when you flip it, I'm just naturally flipping it right there, putting my butts basically elbow where they want them to go. So I'm going to be the screener, you can be the passer, so the next person up can be the passer. You get 2 chances to get open. If you don't get open, you don't get a shot. If you do get open, go ahead and shoot it. You can curl it, one dribble floater, anything you want. We good? Here we go. Go. Good, good. Nice, nice. Curl. Good. That's right. And stop. Now, he did a great job of getting open. You should just curl that. You know what I mean? Get to the lane. That's okay. Next group up. So everybody's down here. Let's just have one guy pass it. And then you guys can rotate up who passes it. So everybody down here. Yep, we're going to have 2 guys pass. That's fine. Everybody else is down here. Okay? And then we'll rotate up who those guys are. Ready? Go. You get 2 chances to get open. Good. Good, you don't have it. Good. That's fine. That's fine. Here we go. And if they don't have that, hold up. My fault. If they don't get open, let him use the screen again the second time. Yep, here we go. Go. Good. Use it. Use it. Good. Go. Good. That's fine. Finish it. Good. Done. Come on, come on, come on. Use it. Use it. Use it. Nice. Good. Don't have it. Use it. Use it again. Use it again. Nice job. Good job. That's good action right there. Good action right there. Next up. Next up. Good, use it. Nice, good. Don't have anything, use it. Yep, perfect. Good. Now we're using screens. Now we're using screens. Good job. Good, use it, use it. Nice, curl it, finish it. Good, good. Come on. Use it, use it, use it. Nice, come on, curl. Nice shot, finish it. Good job, baby. Good job. You guys are doing really good. Really good. Come on. Good. Don't have anything. awesome, actually, one of the better groups that I've seen. But they could see they were patient, and they started using their body a little more physical. That's something I would highly encourage, is making them do that. Now, what we're going to do is I'm going to let you guys go live with the drill that you guys saw yesterday. So all I need is, I need you two to have basketballs. One of you guys can be right here on the baseline. One of you guys over there on the baseline. You're going to guard him. You're going to guard him. You two are going to be right in front of the free throw line. So you're going to be over there extended. You're over there extended. You two are going to be right behind him past that little peace line right here. Okay? And I'm going to get these balls out of the way just to make sure we're good. Now, you guys are going to try to beat all four of them. Okay? You've got to stay within the lane line and the out-of-bounds line. So you're not allowed to cross the lane line. You're not allowed to cross out-of-bounds line. The other thing is you're not allowed to turn your back to no spin moves. Because I want you to handle pressure. So you're guarding me like crazy. And I know what the good news is? You got two other guys helping you. So if you get beat, you're okay. You're not allowed to steal the ball from him, but you are allowed to follow him. So you're allowed to jab him in his shoulders. You're allowed to follow him, whatever you want. I'm here. Hey, he steals it from me. He stuffs it right back in his chest. Then I'm going. He turns me. I get here. Oh, man. Bang, here. Pop off. Eventually, I beat him. Bang, I beat him. Next level's up. He steps up because you're going to be the next ball handler. Now I'm going one-on-one against him. You guard the guy until the next guy says ball. Once he calls you off, then you get off, okay? If you funnel him into a trap, so say you're guarding me and say you turn me this way and you're over here ready, trap him for a second and then say, boom, boom, boom. Now you back up just so they feel that pressure of two people guarding, okay? You guys got to get all the way to half court. Once you get to half court, you're done, okay? Ready? Go. Good, 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 good. That's right, right back. No turns, no spinning. Good defense. Good. Next person up. Here we go. Next person up. Throw it up there and go. Roll up. Rotate up. Yep, right there. Number five, you're in right here. Yep. Stay down. Good. Nice. Come on. One more person. That's okay. Nice job. Stay in bounds. Good. Hit the prop. Good. Last one right here. Here we go. Last one. Nice. Good job. Good handle. Stay in bounds. Good. Hit the rock. Next up. Come on. Good. Good defense on Bob. Good. Keep going. Good. That's right. Good. And stop. So that's our next one we would do, is just kind of a ball handling drill. Again, I'm just throwing out drills so you guys can kind of see some of the things we do. Next thing we got is a post drill. We got any post in here? No? Okay, you guys are going to act like you're a post. So number 11, you're right here. 13, you're going to guard. And then I'm going to have number six, you're right there. And everybody else just kind of step off, and you guys can sit down for a second and grab a drink. So here's a drill that I would do in the post. I think post play, most people don't work on post play enough. So I'm going to be the assistant coach. I'm going to be over there. What you're going to do is you're going to start out in the gray area, and you're going to start out right inside the circle. So you've got to have 1 foot inside the semicircle. You've got to be in the gray area. Obviously, gray area, you can kind of put them depending on how good he is. When you smack the ball, you guys are live, which means you're trying to fight for an early position. I'm trying to beat you outside. I have to play behind. So I can't. I don't want to be fronting. I don't want to give up any angles. I want him to work on kind of one-on-one and doubles. When you enter the ball, he's going to try to score. But what's going to happen is as soon as you pass, you're going to touch the elbow, and then you're going to sprint to double team. If he can score before the double team comes, then he scores. If he scores on this side, he gets 2 points. He's rewarded with 2 points, and he gets to stay on offense, make it take it. If the double team comes right here, and he can't score, he's going to have to retreat dribble, and then throw a skip pass to me. I'll be the coach over there. Once you throw the skip pass, the guy that is doubling steps off the court, and now me and him are one-on-one. So basically, you throw it over there, act like you did, and then you're flashing. You have to go post up on this side. Again, he has to play behind you. Once you catch the ball, then it's one-on-one with no double team coming. If you score on this side, you get 1 point. If you don't score at all, defense becomes offense, the passer becomes the defense, and the guy that was just on offense becomes the passer. Okay, that's the kind of rotation. If he does score, then the passer becomes defense. The defender goes to the passer. So you understand, when he claps, you guys meet. You're playing, you're trying to score. But if he doubles you, you got to retreat, dribble, skip. If you skip it to me, he steps off, you're playing one-on-one on the side, okay? Ready? Go. Smack the ball. Yep, go. Good, good, double. Good, that's okay, double. Hold on. Don't be his friend, you're on defense. Yeah, go double the shit out of him. Here we go, go. Go, good, double. Good, perfect. Nice job. Now, snap what happened. Number 13, you go on offense. Number 6, you go on defense. 11 becomes a passer. Good. Hey, 6, you gotta have a foot in the key. Yep, we're ready. Go. Good. Post up. Double. Nice. Good. He gets to stay on offense. 6, you're the passer. 11, you're on defense. 13, you're on offense. Good. You ready? Go. Good. And stop. Now, this is a guard mentality. Most big guys have patience, so they're not throwing up bad shots like that. So they would actually catch the ball. If they get doubled, they would end up backing up and skipping. So for the sake of this drill, I want you to 11 not try to score on this one. Back it up just so they can see the drill real quick. So 11's on offense, 6 is on defense. Yep. Ready? Go. Good. Catch it. Good. Double. You see the double coming. Yes. Back up. Skip. Good. Now you're 1-on-1. So flash. Gotta get open. Get open. Yes. Now you're playing live 1-on-1. Good. Nice job. Perfect. And good. That's what the drill will look like. When you have good patience, big guys really get good at it. Sometimes they might even fake the pass and they beat the double because they're trying to score 2 points on that strong side. Sometimes they'll, you know, funnel their way, but they'll realize if they try to hurry up and score against the double team, then it's probably not a good result. Whereas if they take their time, they'd rather have a one-on-one on the opposite side, because if they score, they get to stay on. So that's one good post drill. One other post drill that I really like is you stay there, 13, you're on that block. And then 6, you're going to be right underneath the rim. And I love this just as finishing goes. There's one more post thing. And this is right here. All it's going to be is you're facing me, you're facing me. I'm just going to toss it to one of them, and they're going to try to score it on you. My rule, again, I don't care if guys foul, so you're allowed to foul the shit out of either one of them. Okay? I don't want you to, when they're up in the air, I don't want you to undercut them, but you can smack the shit out of their arms. Ready? Good. Finish it. Nice. Good. Next up. Go, finish it. Perfect. Here we go. Same thing. Finish it. Nice. Finish it. Good. I know you can foul harder than that. Good. Get there. Nice. That's how it's going to be in the game. Going through that. Good. Go. Finish it. Nice. Good. Finish with that one. Make it a strong hand. Boom. Finish it. Nice. Perfect. Just like that. One more. Good. Finish it. Good. And stop. I would do some drills like that. Obviously, you can put them in different areas, but any kind of finishing with fouls. Big guys don't like when they get contact and they don't get fouls, so that's another really good drill. Now, I need everybody out here. So here's the drill, the next drill, and again, this is a drill that I really like. You're going to have a ball right there. You're good. Actually, scoot over to that block. You can scoot over the block. Give him the ball. You're going to stay there. 11, you're going to go underneath the rim down there without a basketball. 5, you're going to go with the basketball on this block right here. Let me have 2 of you guys go on that wing over there, and then 2 of you guys go on that wing over there. You don't even need a basketball, number 9. You're behind number 8 without a basketball. Yeah, just let that go. All right, this is one of my favorite drills right here, and what this does is it works on rebounding, rewards them by getting shots, and it's kind of a toughness drill. So what's going to happen is number 13, and you're going to throw the ball to number 8. You're not allowed to travel, so if you can throw an outlet pass or an advance pass, you can go ahead and throw this up. If you can't get it to him, then you're going to have to take a dribble or two and then skip the ball and throw it online. Once you pass, you're going to sprint down and try to catch a shoot from your range. If you're a 3-point shooter, ball. Shoot the 3. If you're a 2-point shooter, ball. Shoot the 2. Once you shoot, it doesn't matter if you make it or miss it, you're off. Okay? What's going to happen is on the shot, so as soon as you pass the ball, you're crashing, you're blocking out. Whoever gets the rebound becomes the next shooter going down. Okay? That's the only thing that we're doing. So it's basically you pass ahead, you sprint for a full court shot, you shoot the shot, you go to the back of the passing line that you just received it. So once you shoot, it doesn't matter if you make or miss, you're going to go right behind number 14. Okay? Once you pass it back to him, you're crashing number 6, you're blocking out. Whoever gets the rebound down here will be the next shooter. If, say they're down there and they're still going on, then hold the ball for a second just like you would in a game. You wouldn't pass it to somebody that's not ready for it. Okay? We good on that? You got the rock. Simultaneous. Go. Both guys at the same time. Go. Good. So they're done. Good. You're going to block out number 4. Go. Good. Whoever gets the rebound. Good. Whoever doesn't get the rebound stays. Let's go. Sprint. Full court shot. Nice. Good. Whoever gets it. shooter. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Good. Don't throw bad passes. You can take an extra drill if you need to. Go. Good. Get open, get open, get open. Good. Let's go, let's go. Next up, go. Perfect. Pass it up and go. Pass it up and go. Good. Knock down, knock down. Nice job. Good. Get that rebound. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Wait till they go. Yep. Now go, now go. Go. Keep going, keep going. Now go. Perfect. Go, 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 go. That's what you have to do sometimes. If they're still going on, you just have to have them dribble the ball and kind of hold it out for a second. Perfect, perfect. Let's go, let's go. Keep going. Nice job. Good job, number six. Waiting on him. Good job. Good. Couple more, couple more. Nice. Good job. Go, 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 go. Good. Nice. Knock down. And stop. That's another drill that I like doing, just kind of mix it up. Next thing we're going to do is number 13 and number 6. You guys are a team. I want you guys right down here on the baseline. Okay? Number 4 and number 9, you guys are a team. You guys are an offense with the ball. Number 11 and number 8, you guys are going to be on defense right here guarding them. And number 14 and 5, you guys are on that baseline without a basketball. So just throw that ball in the soccer net. Something. Okay, here's what it is. It's 2-on-2, basically full court, continuous. You guys are going to play, so you two are teammates the entire drill, you two are teammates the entire drill, you two are teammates the entire drill, same with you guys. You guys are playing. You guys get one pass in the half court, and you get 3 dribbles every time you touch the ball. So it's quick. It is not going to be we're going to just play it and get a perfect shot. It is, you got one pass, so you can drive, kick, and then you have to score. Okay? Or it's a drive and score right away. Once you guys shoot the ball, regardless, make or miss, you don't rebound the ball, what's going to happen is you guys are immediately going to be on defense. They're going to be immediately on offense, okay? There's 2 variations of this drill. So as soon as you shoot, you guys aren't even worried about anything as far as defensively goes. You guys are off, okay? You guys immediately go to defense. You guys immediately go to offense, okay? I thought you guys should have a ball. So as soon as you shoot, my fault, they take off and push it, whereas you guys get your own rebound. Okay, does that make sense? That was my fault on this first variation. The second variation, they don't have the ball. So as soon as they shoot the ball, you guys take off and go. These two guys are going to get back on defense. You guys get your own the defensive rebound and then go out of bounds and wait. Okay, ready? Go. Good. Attack. 2, 3. Shot. Go, 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 go. Offense, go. Attack, attack. They're in back mode. Good. 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 Offense, get back. Offense, get back. Come on, get back. Good. Come on, come on. Good. Good. Let's go, let's go. Turnover. Let's go. Gotta get back. Good. Playing full court and alive. Good. Offense, get back. Offense, get back. Good. Don't leave early. Don't leave early. Offense, don't leave early. Good. Go, go, go. Good. Don't leave early. Don't leave early. Nice. Come on. Good. Go, 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 go. Don't leave early. Now hold up, hold up, hold up. Hold ball real quick. Hold ball real quick. Hold ball real quick. Now some of this comes into just being smart. If your guy's going to lay the ball up, don't just run after them like this. You know they're coming. Get back. Right? Be smart. You know what the next thing is. You guys, the wings are leaving early. Don't leave early. Okay, we ready? So you guys got to wait until after they shoot the ball. Once the ball hits the rim, you guys can go. Okay? Go. Good. Play it. Nice. Once the ball hits the rim. Once the ball hits the rim, we'll make that one little rule change. Go. Now we're live. Now we're live. Good. Stop the ball.